a very interesting and common topic, the role, responsibility, and the duties of a traffic controller, a flagman. Dear friends and fellows, a person with minimum two flags standing on a work site, giving signals to moving vehicles, plants, and equipment. He or she is a traffic control person, or sometimes he is known as a signaler or a flagman. In this training session, we'll learn what is the responsibility of a flagman, how a flagman can control the flow of traffic efficiently, effectively, and safely. What are the requirements for the suitability of this job as a traffic controller or a flagman? What a flagman should know prior to start his duty, and what to do during his assignment as a traffic controller, and what personal protective equipment and other requirements. So, without wasting time, let's get started. The major role and responsibility of a traffic controller or a flagman is: number one, stop, slow, and safely direct traffic through work or construction sites. Number two, protect workers in the construction zone by regulating traffic flow. Number three, give traffic control directions and signals clearly and precisely so that motorists understand their meaning. And number four, keep the flow of traffic moving with as few delays as possible. But remember, you have to use traffic control persons when other methods of traffic control are not adequate, not practicable. Always use barriers, barricades, lane control devices, traffic signal lights, sign trucks, and other methods as appropriate instead of and or in addition to traffic control persons to ensure the safety of all the workers. Dear friends and fellows, you are on the platform of Safety First Life. If you are first time on this channel, kindly subscribe it and press the bell icon for all future notifications. And if you find the video informative, then like, comment, and share it with your friends and fellows. If you are acting as a flagman or a traffic control person, then you must know, number one, the overall traffic protection plan and layout of the traffic control zone. Number two, your duties, roles, and responsibilities. Number three, that you have the right training for this job and that you understand your duties. Number four, what activities will be done on the work or construction site. For example, paving, grading, loading, unloading, or any other earthworks. Number five, what equipment is present and how the equipment will be operated. For example, scrapers, trucks, graders, etc. Number six, what personal protective equipment is required. Number seven, practices and procedures for that job, how to stop and slow down the traffic, where to stand, etc. The traffic control zone will vary depending on the speed allowed on the roadway, volume of traffic, weather conditions, if there is a curve or hill, etc. Number eight, what communication methods will be used, including how to use radios, hand signals, etc. Dear friends and fellows, we are talking about the information that a flagman or a traffic controller should grab before starting his own responsibilities. Point number nine, be sure you have adequate eyesight and hearing ability to do this job safely. Number 10, how communication will be handled if there is a need for a third traffic control person, such as when the work zone is around curves or hills where sight lines to the other end of the work zone are obstructed. Number 11, that the stop slow sign you will use is in good repair. For example, undamaged, clean. Number 12, that mirrors are in place and at appropriate distances to give motorists enough warning to slow down. Number 13, how to report incidents, near misses, accidents, etc. And number 14, that a traffic control person, a flagman, should never leave his position unattended. For example, know what the arrangements are for meals and breaks. You have to go through all these 14 points prior to start your responsibility as a flagman, as a traffic controller. Let us understand now what is the responsibility of a traffic control person, a flagman, when he or she is engaged in controlling traffic on site. Dear friends and fellows, when controlling traffic, a traffic control person, a flagman should, number one, always stay alert. The situation can change very quickly. Number two, be visible. Stand where you can see traffic and be seen by the traffic. Number three, think ahead and plan your escape route. Know where you will move to and if a motorist drives too close. Number four, stand alone, which in this case means don't stand in a group of people or beside or in a vehicle or other distractions. Drivers must be able to see you clearly. Number five, stand the correct distance from the work area. This position will vary with the visibility, speed, and volume of traffic. In general, this part is halfway between the beginning of the taper or detour zone and the traffic control person sign. Don't stand too close to the taper or in the travel lane. Number six, keep visual contact with the other traffic control person if you are not using radios. Number seven, work as a team with other traffic control persons. Always check with other traffic control person to see if it is safe to allow traffic to move. When two or more traffic control persons are required to work as a team at a work site, responsibility for coordination of changes in traffic flow could be assigned to one person. Number eight, hold the stop slow sign away from your body and in the driver's line of sight. Number nine, raise your free hand with the palm facing the driver to stop traffic. Dear friends and fellows, we are talking about how a flagman will act to control a traffic flow. Point number 10, allow time for the vehicle to stop safely by turning the sign when the vehicle is at an appropriate distance away for the speed it is traveling. Point number 11, after stopping the first vehicle, move to a safe position where the incoming next vehicle can see you. Number 12, be aware of everything going on around you, behind you, lane beside you, etc. Number 13, when you are ready to release traffic, return to your position outside the travel lane. Confirm with the other traffic control person, is it safe to let traffic move? Turn the sign to slow and with your free arm, signal to drivers to proceed. Point number 14, don't assume a vehicle will stop until it has actually come to a full and complete stop. Point number 15, don't look away from incoming traffic. Point number 16, don't do any other activity other than controlling traffic. Point number 17, don't use other devices other than your communication radio, which may distract you or impair your sight, hearing, or take attention from the job. These devices include personal music players, cell phones, etc. Only use a cell phone for on-site emergency communications if permitted. Dear friends and fellows, you are on the platform of Safety First Life. Today we are talking about the roles and responsibilities of a traffic control person, a flagman, how to control and manage traffic at a construction site. Point number 18, don't participate in arguments with motorists. Be polite, don't retaliate, stay back and stay safe. If necessary, record the incident and report it to your supervisor. Point number 19, don't try to enforce situations that appear to be breaking highway traffic acts. For example, speeding, dangerous driving, driving while impaired, etc. Make a note of the license plate on the vehicle and discuss with your supervisor. Call the police or emergency services for assistance if required. And point number 20, don't use radio communication when blasting activities are occurring. These are very important 20 points that every flagman or a traffic control person must know: how to control traffic, how to manage traffic, and how to carry out his duties effectively and efficiently. Let us understand now what personal protective equipment must be provided to a flagman, a traffic controller. Number one, a vest or other clothing that is appropriate class of high visibility material. Number two, a hard hat. Number three, safety footwear. Number four, eye protection. And number five, hearing protection. These are the minimum requirements. Dear friends and fellows, a flagman must assure that clothing or eye and hearing protection don't interfere with his ability to see and hear while working. There are some other safety tips. Number one, use a sign that is designed specifically to direct traffic. Stop, slow. Be sure the sign is in good repair and meets the height and size requirements for your jurisdiction as per the traffic rules and regulations. Number two, carry spare batteries for the communication radio. In case if a battery is not working, you can easily replace it with a new one. Number three, for poor light or night conditions, use a flashlight fitted with a red signaling wand and carry spare batteries for the flashlight. A reflective material on your hard hat and clothing will also help you be more visible at night. Number four, for poor light or night conditions, where possible, stand under a street light or install overhead lighting that will allow motorists to see the traffic control person more easily. And this way, you can save yourself from vehicular accidents. Number five, dress according to the weather and be prepared for when the weather changes, depending on the environmental conditions. Clothing may include sunglasses, sunscreen, and insect repellent, high visibility rain gear, warm layered clothing, including gloves, winter boots, and hard hat liners. Point number six, where appropriate, carry protection from wildlife. Point number seven, use a portable horn or whistle to alert other workers when necessary. And point number eight, carry a book for note taking. You can record the incidents, near misses, accidents, and other similar happenings during your work shift. Dear friends and fellows, on a congested construction site, the role of traffic controller or a flagman is vital, very important, but It depends. He or she knows his responsibilities, what to do in the case if there is an incident, if there is an accident, if there is a near miss, how to meet accidental situations, how to handle emergency circumstances, what PPE is required, what are his site-specific requirements, what to know before starting the duties as a traffic controller, as a flagman, and what must be done during controlling and managing traffic on a work site. You are well clear now about the roles and responsibilities of a traffic control person or a flagman. And that's all for today. Training session is over now. If you have any question, please ask in the comment section. Thanks for watching. And don't forget to like, comment, and share the video. Hope to see you soon with a new HSC tutorial. Till then, take care. Good luck and goodbye. You